niggas screw their face up at me. On some real shit, son, they don't want beef. I cock that, aim that shit out the window and spray the innocent.
So I had a conversation with Jesus Christ the other day. And Jehovah told me to tell the people the secrets to being a sexy Nigerian butterscotch man like myself today. But I also had a conversation with Mr. 50 Cent. And this day, the people want Dre to die. Is it because he's sexy? Why do they want him to die? He said, Rotimi. He said, Olu Rotimi. Listen to me. Uh-huh. He said, if you want to survive this show, you have to be sexy. So I'm drinking greens from the earth. I'm drinking greens from the earth because I do not want to die. Why would I want to die? Why do they want me to die? That me, Olu Rotimi, is going to survive. I'm a survivor. I'm a survivor, baby. I don't want that. Kills Brazilian clay from the Amazons. I love you.
What the fuck? This is what happened when you put a bunch of lying motherfuckers in a classroom. What the fuck did y'all have a class reunion for? Put this plan together so y'all could just kill Angie in the end. She had that shit mapped out. And nobody trusts each other. How many times I gotta tell you? Nobody wins when the fucking family feuds. You motherfuckers ain't shit. Angie put her life and career on the line time after time for a bunch of motherfuckers that don't even like her. Oh, God. You kill Angie and Dre still running his greasy bell pepper nose ass around here alive than a bitch. Oh, God. It's over.
What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Mark Dark, and I'm back with another power video. If you're new, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, like the video, and leave your comments below. Now, tonight, we're going to be talking about Power Season 5, and we're going to be talking about your boy Dre. Just how in the hell did Dre survive? It's bullshit. Ain't no way in the hell he should have lived at all. The writers, you know, they love him. They want him to stay alive. And it pissed me off. How the hell did this dude stay alive? Like, he's invincible all of a sudden? Dre's invincible all of a sudden. I just, like, really? And they had two different encounters. And this dude just survived both of them. You know what I'm saying? Straight survived both of them. The second encounter, it had to be like 10 cats in there. And he survived it somehow, some way. In the comment section, let me know. Let the people know. How you feel about your boy Dre? How you feel about the writers letting this fool survive once again? So let's break it down. First off, this guy was really, he was smashing. His daughter, you know what I'm saying, could have got kidnapped, could have got hurt. And somehow, some way, Dre still, he still kills two of them. Two of the Jimenez cartel, he still kills them. And his baby mom's was right there. Like I told you guys in the recap, she was in there fighting too. Like, really? Like, what the hell is going on? They ain't got no clothes on or nothing. You know what I'm saying? They pretty much got sneak attacked and still killed them. That's how I knew, like, this motherfucker, he was going to survive. That's how I knew. I knew, like, man, once they did that, I'm like, okay, I see what time it is. And he tells his baby mom to go, you know, pretty much go into hiding, go to her mom's house or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like, and then I'm glad the fans let me know. His daughter, why in the hell do she look younger? When we seen her, I want to say a couple seasons ago, this little girl was bigger than that. When Kanan had her, how all of a sudden she looked younger now? What the hell is going on with Dre? How the hell is his daughter so young all of a sudden? She ain't grow up or nothing? Like, what are y'all doing? It don't make sense. And then Dre had the nerve. He was talking to Angela, had the nerve to say, yeah, just look out for me and the daughter. Forget the moms. You know what I'm saying? Forget the mother. Like, damn, Dre just played her. Forget the mother, though? Dre, I mean, this dude is a savage, man. He's a savage. He lied to Two Bits, talking about Brock and all that shit. Like, dude, you know Brock is dead. You finished him off after Kanan cut off his tongue. And you're going to sit up here and lie straight to 2Bits. And this is when 2Bits is like, all right, you're going to keep lying about Brock. Remember, Kanan told him about Brock. But Kanan lied to 2Bits. But Dre also lied. He lied to 2Bits as well. You should have just told him, like, yeah, your boy Kanan crazy as hell. He made me finish him off. He bitched me out. Just say that, Dre. You know what I'm saying? Stop trying to act hard. You made the mistake of telling 2Bits all the information. So now he knows. He knows you got an armor on. You know what I'm saying? He knows pretty much where you're going to be at. And Dre, you just clueless. How many mistakes, you know what I'm saying, are you going to make? After the cartel came for Dre, man, ain't no way I would have been talking to nobody. There's no way. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't have been saying shit to nobody. You don't know who set it up. You can't trust nobody. But Dre, you know, knowing him, he don't care. He think 2Bits and Spanky is his boys. But in reality, boy, they going against you. They trying to work with Tommy. And they ain't fooling with you no more. It's like everybody wants Dre's. Everybody wants Dre dead. And Spanky was like, I don't even know why I like this nigga. Like, really? You know what I'm saying? Like, Dre is a fool. How in the hell? Like, I'm still sitting here. How in the hell did he survive? Why did they give us two scenes like that? They pissed us off with the first one. The first one, it was like, okay, I see what it is. Then the second one is what really pissed me off. So everybody can't shoot now? I understand what Tommy was doing, but what about everybody else? They all know he got a vest on. 2Bits told him. So why in the hell is no one hitting this cat? He get hit in the thigh. That's it? No headshots or nothing? He don't get hit nowhere else? Like, really? And to make it sad, this cat actually dropped like two or three of them. Like, how the hell is Dre doing this? Like I said, Max Payne, like, what did this dude, like, what type of special powers do Dre have? How all of a sudden is he just unstoppable, like the Matrix or some shit? He was dodging shit like Neo and shit. Like, he's the chosen one. Like, really? When that shit started happening and I seen he wasn't dying, I'm like, oh, okay. These motherfuckers, you know, what are they doing? Like, it's only, I'm like, he's pretty much trapped. Like, where is he going to go? He's trapped. And then this bitch jumped out the motherfucking window. Then I knew, I'm like, oh, this is what we going to be doing. This is what really pissed me off in this episode. Because it was like, they kind of just rushed this whole scene and they made another reason why Dre should be alive. Like, really? You know what I'm saying? Another reason. This killer's punk ass. But it's always a reason. Like, this whole season, if you've been noticing, I know you guys have, it's always a reason to keep Dre alive. We got to keep him alive because we got to use him to get closer to Jimenez. We can't kill him yet. We got to keep Dre alive because we need him to testify against Alicia and Jimenez. Like, why does this cat always have a reason on why not to die? Dre needs to go, and to be honest with you guys, he has a lot of luck. These writers love him. I don't know when this dude's going to die. I thought it was over for him. I thought it was really over for your boy. But he survived somehow, some way, jumping through windows and shit. After being shot in the damn thigh, then jumped straight into a damn van. Like he's never been shot at all. This motherfucker had all types of energy. Signed a contract to agree to testify against Alicia. So you're going to lie on her. I want to see what Dre actually going to do. He signed the contract, but we're going to see what this cat really going to say. He said he going to do it, but he going to say Tommy and Ghost did the shit. Like, for real? Boy, you messing all up. You messing all up. There's no way in the hell. It's unrealistic, like I said. I don't necessarily agree with this whole Dre standing alive shit. I mean, if you're going to make him stay alive, make it seem realistic. He just pretty much dodged two damn murder attacks on his ass. They tried to take his ass out, and he survived both of them. And in both encounters, he was snuck. How in the hell is he surviving this? It's one man against all these other cats, these killers, and he's just unstoppable. Dre's unstoppable now, man. So my predictions for Dre for next season, I just don't know. I just don't know. Who's going to kill him? It's the question. Because it seems like, you know, from what Courtney Kemp said, this is just the beginning. This is just the beginning for Dre. He's going to keep surviving somehow, some way in this total bullshit. Somebody need to do something to him. Beat the hell out of him or something. Smacked it. Beat his ass. Shoot him. I don't care. Dre needs to suffer for what he did. And it's crazy how they keep making this dude last the whole season. He's lucky as hell. And this is what pisses the fans off. They're like, man, how the hell did he survive both of these attacks? Both of them blindsided and still survived. I'm getting tired of this shit, man. I'm getting tired of the shit. Dre better die next season. He better die next season or it's going to be some damn problems. But you guys let me know what you think about Dre surviving. Leave your comments, theories, everything down below. And I will continue to bring you more power content this week. But it's your boy, Mark Dark. I'm out. Peace.
I do not gang bang. But play me like I'm pussy, I will pull up and bang bang. Niggas get knocked out, just say they gon' pop out. Hop out, ooh, wop out, and then the whole block out. Blow the whole stock out, and not about what I'm about. I'm a one-man band. I bring the drum out and dump it.